Welcome. On today's episode, we are diving into the funnel chart. This visual is great for sequentially analyzing data as it moves through stages. What's that mean? Let's look at it. In this example, you can see we have leads that qualify to solutions, then proposals, and finally closing the deal or finalizing. What a funnel chart will do is allow you to analyze what percentage progressed to the next step. You can do percentage of previous, percentage of the first, lots of different things. This visual is great to use when you're incorporating with other visuals so you can filter and interact with it. And in today's video, I'm gonna fully equip you with how to use this visual. So let's dive into Power BI. All right, so here we are. We have this visual. I have the file saved in GitHub. You can access it and follow along. But what we're gonna do is first talk about the visual, and then we're gonna reconstruct it using some different things. You'll go through all the formatting steps, everything with the labels to how to fully control and optimize this visual. So let's look at it first. What this is doing, the funnel visual in general, the funnel chart, is if we have opportunities, something we're trying to sell, and if we look at the data just to get a gist of it, you'll see there's an opportunity, where did it go, and the stage the opportunity is in. So it's a straightforward data about things moving through a pipeline. But let's look at it. So what this is saying is that from 268 leads we received, 35% of those, or 94, made it to the qualify stage, and then 28% of those, or 74, made it to solutioning, and et cetera, and it goes down. What you can also look at, and we'll get into details of this, is data value percent of the previous. I was looking at actually percent of the first there. So 5% is the percentage of the first 268, or percentage of the previous, and how it's 35, 79, 50, 38 of each step. Again, I'll talk through that in a second. But what's cool and how you can really use this is when you need to progress the pipeline and then analyze it. So say, for example, we have opportunities by segment and region. Maybe we want to know, okay, what's going on in Central? Well, when you click it, you can get a lot of interactivity with this thing. It's a great way, again, to tell the pipeline, to talk about what's going through, how this works. So let's dive into Build It. You will have a full understanding of how to use this at the end of this video. So let's go. What we're going to do is I'm going to first, I'll shrink this down, make it like half the size. We'll build one next to each other. I'll just make a brand new one. So we have something called opportunities. If we click it, 487 total opportunities. All right, well, we want to see those progress through each stage. So within the visualization section, you can see we'll pick waterfall or funnel. And now we have the funnel chart. And so it's not breaking out yet. How does this work? So you can segment it by category. In this case, we're doing it by sales stage. So I'm going to add that category. And very simply like that, you start to see how this formulates the idea of transcending levels for every visual. So let's talk about the formatting options of this. You can tell, and it's so important that when you're building these things, don't just stop. Like you can set it up. You need to go through the subtle details of formatting to just make it look better. That's gonna increase the overall interaction and engagement with your solution and what you're doing. So let's talk through the different formatting options. As you can see, it's subtle, but it tells a point. When we look at color, color should always have an intention. So in this case, we know solution's orange. Everything that is orange is solution. You want to have coordinated colors. So let's talk about how to set that up, as well as then labels that kind of stand out and they're more bold. So first, we have our visual here. Let's set up the title. The properties on the right-hand side, size, style, title, colors, data labels. We'll get on all the labels. We'll start with some easy stuff here first. So first for the title, let's call it opportunities by stage, and we'll make it white, and we'll make it din, and we'll center it, make it bold, and we'll capitalize the word stage. What we're doing is just making something that's going to be similar to right what's over here right next to it. Oh, I think I did some padding too. I always like to play with the padding. Zero at the top. So we have the same padding. All right, so let's keep progressing. Now, one thing that's subtle but it's important is we want to make sure we can clearly see the y-axis. You'll see the percentages. I'll talk about those and how you can make those pop out. But let's start with making sure that we can now see every category. So the way that we do that is at the category label section. Very simplistically, we're going to set this sucker up. I'm going to click white and we're done. Din, that's it. So now that's locked in. Let's go and set these calculations to show up differently. So that's going to be the conversion rate. And right now it's gray and we'll make it green and bold and one size bigger. So it just kind of jumps out. But what's going to be important too is that we understand the percentages and how to set these up. So let's lock in the colors within the color section. It's going to default to putting everything as one. If you click show all, you can then set them up. So we're going to say leads blue, qualify is purple, the solution itself is going to be orange, proposal yellow, finalize green for bringing it home. And now let's talk about the labels internally within it. This is important, and I'll go over this again. So you have so much space. Firstly, putting the labels on the outside end just doesn't make sense. Use the space you have, put them on the inside. So that's a give me right there. But then now with what's in there, you can choose what you want the label to be. So right now it's just the value, but we have space. We need to tell a greater story. So let's do that. So you can say the percentage of the first. So what this means is percentage of the first that to get to finalize 5.22% made it there. And it goes upwards from there. Percentage of previous. I like this one because it just kind of tells the story of how many progressed. But again, they both are important. They're both valuable. So if you pick percentage of previous, it's going to show how much from the previous percentage transcends to the next category. But an easier way is when you combine both of them. It even helps tell the story more. So this is what I was talking about in the beginning, but data value percent of first, that means that in the finalized stage, there's 14 opportunities that made it there, which is 5.22% of the total. Or if we go percentage of previous, we can see that there's still 14, but that's 37% of the proposal. So once you get to proposal, there's a 37% chance you're gonna finalize. It's a great way to say what's the probability to get to the next stage of something. And then that might change because again, the interactivity is if I click central, well, now it's slightly smaller, 35%, 38%, 40%. So the probability of getting from proposal to finalize is about 3% greater when you're in the West. It's that kind of insights that you can derive from these visuals that make it very valuable. It's a very cool thing to have in your tool belt. So now when we have this set up, I mean, I think we're pretty much rocking here. You have, if you desire, you can set the background. I have it off. Oh, the final thing, it's a newer update, is how we can do background. And I just love doing this with day labels. I think it makes the visualization of it so much better. So if I close all these out, you can see there's a slight box right here. So what I'm gonna do is for the data labels, I'm gonna turn the background on and I'll set it to black. And just to see what's going on here, if I do the transparency to zero, it pretty much like makes a hole. So it's kind of a cool look. I usually go about a third, somewhere on 33%. It gives that vibe of like, here's the value, look at it. But then also when it's outside, it still looks sharp. So overall, that's how you use the funnel chart. You can knock it out. You can use it, add it to your dashboards. If this is valuable, please subscribe, like. I make videos all the time. I'd love for you to keep watching them. Please leave me a comment. Let me know if I can do anything to help you. Have a good day. Bye.